When you were 16, you were out on your own, you were making money on your own.
Yeah, but
you were
when
I was the law.
Yeah, but you got to realize when I was 16, it's not like people that you would think is 16.
Why is that?
Well, the person that's raised on the street is 16 years old is generally about 55 in their minds.
Because they see so many experiences
quick. You know, they've been through more life and death situations, and they've been through 10 times more than the average person sitting there doing what their mother says, going back and forwards to school. In other words, life is not in a school book.
Yeah. Do you want to look back at that early period of your life and before the 60s and say, boy, something went wrong because I got on this track and I was in and out of prison, you know, and I went to foster homes and then my mother would take me, then I'd go see my grandmother, then I'd go back and see my mother and then she would run away and somehow, did that shape you? Did it make a difference?
Well, see, that doesn't even compute in my world because, like, there is no wrong.
There's no wrong?
I don't do any wrong. I wouldn't do anything that was wrong. If I did something that I would regret, then I would punish myself for it. And I wouldn't stand here and beat myself in the head with a hammer. That wouldn't make much sense.
Yeah.
You know, so you got a parallel universe. You got two worlds. One world, everything is a lie and everything is wrong and you can never do anything right. According to anybody else, I've never done anything right. There's always been someone to say that I wasn't right and I did it wrong.
Yeah.
But in the world that I live in, I've never made a bad move in my whole life.
In the world you have lived in,
sure,
you would not rewrite any episode, you would not change anything, you do not look back and say, my God, I took a wrong turn there.
No.
None of it.
No. No.
Not once.
I wouldn't be here if I did it. So you got to realize there's no slack in my act.
Yeah.
I can't. In other words, you go down to St. Louis,
right?
And you get off the bus and you're broke. Right. You go to the phone and call moms.
Right.
I don't. I go to the alley and get a tire iron.
And do what?
And whatever I got to do to survive, that's what I do.
And so what's the difference in you and me then?
Because you don't know how to survive. You're weak. You have emotions. You play little games with your mind. You chase your tail.
Yeah, but you know, you have said before about your life that you needed love and you needed family and you needed friends, and that's the one thing that every man needs.
No, you misunderstood. I never said anything like that. You might paraphrase what I said into thinking I said something like that. Everything is love. There's nothing that isn't love. Even the confusion is love in one form or another. It's misguided. Love is a word that we use to supplement for God. Or I would rather use the word intelligence. If you're going to use the word love, use the word intelligence. Because love is misunderstood in so many different ways and fashions.
Do you need to be loved?
Loved. I am loved.
By whom?
I am love.
Are you loved?
I am love.
Are you loved?
All the way.
Okay.
I'm around the world with it. Ain't you seen it? You're 15 times standing in the fire with it, man.
Meaning what?
Meaning I'm taking up all the slack for you, I'm carrying you around, Nixon.
Yeah.
I still got you. Hey, Regan, hey, Ronnie. I didn't tell him that was your gun that shot that guy. I didn't tell him that gun came out of that trailer that came over there. I held my butt on you, down, Ronnie, old crime partner.
Yeah.
You dig what I'm saying? In other words, I'm intertwined in your very soul, man. You give me my rights. My father died in the battlefield for my rights. Then I go down to L.A. and some district attorney wants to get rich and make a lot of money.
Yeah.
He's got something to sell and good. He dumps it over on me. It's okay.
Yeah.
There's only one poor guy down here. He's nobody. And they overlook the fact that I had already been brother in this penitentiary for 22 years. I speak big in that yard out there.
But did they overlook that fact or not?
Sure they overlooked it.
Well, how did they overlook it?
They took my rights, man.
Yeah.
You don't take my rights. You'd rumble the graveyard from here to the unknown
but
soldier.
But you respect power, and the system works this way. The state has power, and if, in fact, you violate the laws of the state, they have the power to put you away.
Sure.
You respect that?
Sure. I did for 22 years.
That's right.
That's why I'm mad. That's why I'm mad. I held that up. But when I was a child, I used to be crying and bitching, right. And the old man said, you do the crying, boy? And I said, yeah. And he said, well, shut up and do your time. So when I get back out, and your kids pick me up out of the street and pick me up out of the garbage can, All I want is the little girls. I love them little girls. I'm following little girls around. I ain't got no thought in my mind about nothing.
Right.
I'm not trying to stop nobody. I'm playing music. I'm free. It took me 22 years to get out of this hallway.
This was Haight-Ashbury, 1966.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They picked me up. They said, kid, 16-year-old kid. I said, where do you sleep? He said, where I lay down? I said, well, don't you have to have an apartment? He said, no, I sleep in the park. I said, how do you do that? He said, sleeping bag. I said, is that right? What do you eat? He said, food. I said, man, where do you get it? He said, wherever I can. I said, don't you have a job? And he laughed at me. He said, no, we're not the diggers.
Yeah.
So I went down and I looked around. I said, hey, this is love here.
Yeah.
This is love here.
The best time of your life.
Yeah. It was the only time in my life. I never had no life before. That's always been in here with these guys, man. It's always been in jail. I never had no life outside. I've been locked up since I was 9 years old.
Well, now you're in 1967. You're in Haight-Ashbury in San Francisco.
I got out. I'm free. I'm free.
You're free.
I got better sense than break the law, man. You're not going to break no law. If you break the law, you put yourself in jail.
You're in Haight-Ashbury. And what's the magnetism of you? Why did they come to you? Why were they attracted to you?
Well,
those young girls that you were looking for.
All right, here's the thing. In the penitentiary, you learn this.
All right.
Don't lie. Don't lie, man. If someone catches you in a lie, you leave yourself open to get snuffed. And all my life, I've lived in the eye of that tell the truth. Pay your debts. Don't get involved in other people's business. Do your number, do your time. And you learn to stand on your own. So I'm walking, I'm standing on my own. People see me standing on my own. Not too many people in your world can do that. But I don't realize that at that particular time. I don't realize how weak and mindless you people are. See, I'm judging you by the people okay. in here.
And you're at Haight-Ashbury, and you meet these young women, young girls,
young people.
And you're playing a guitar, and and everything is happy. And there's a lot of love, and you're not lying to them. You're just singing songs, and they're coming to you. What's going on? What's happening?
The world is happening. The war was going on. Yeah. All the children wanted to stop the war.
Yeah.
They wanted peace on earth.
Yeah.
And they come to me, and they says. And I says, they says, well, we want this, this, and this. And I said, okay. And they said, let's go demonstrate. And I said, no, I'm not going to go demonstrate. I'm not going to go get put in jail. And they said, well, wouldn't you give your love to stop the war? And wouldn't you give your love to save the world? I said, would you give your love to save the world? And they said, yeah. I said, well, how much would you give to save the world? And they said, we would give all. I lay my body down. You dig? I give all to save the world. I said, well, if that's you, then you can do that. But I just gave 22 years of my life, and I'm not going back in there for God or nobody else. So if you want to do that, that's your road.
Uh-huh. What was it like for you? Was there...
I passed through Haight-Ashbury.
Yeah.
I threw my pistol off of that bridge over there.
You did?
Yeah.
Because...
I got tired of carrying pistols. Yeah. I thought, well, I don't need to shoot anybody, so I threw the pistol over.
But this was the best time of your life, you said. You had a family
was,
of people that loved
I
you.
Had
a lot of,
free.
Lot of girls. You'd like...
I didn't say, you know, you say, I didn't
okay,
say
I'm asking.
People loved
I'm only
me.
Asking.
You know?
I'm only asking.
I said the people were loved. That was love. It was happening there.
Yeah.
That was happening. But you got to realize I came in on the end of that.
Right.
And I only went through that. I never got stuck up in that.
Yeah.
Because I seen the pitfalls. I seen the speed freaks.
Yeah.
I seen the falling of it. I seen it falling. I'm very aware when it comes to seeing things.
You were an ex-con and you were wary.
I was, yeah, I'm not going to get busted or go to jail again.
Yeah.
That was my thought.
So
I used to hold this up, Sam. One positive thought.
Yeah.
I'll never go back to jail again because I'll never break the law again.
So you had a family, though.
I had a family. See, there you go.
A family had you. But
no.
You see, you were trying to make it suggest I'm saying this, and I'm saying, did you or did you not?
No, I never thought of a family. I don't hang on to people, man.
Right.
I've never had anybody I hold on to.
Why
not even in my mind?